All right. So this video, it'll probably be pretty quick. I'm going to explain how I'm troubleshooting magnetos. It seems like my latest projects have been bad magnetos, bad connections, no spark, that kind of thing. A bunch of this stuff. Some of these old gas compressors. This John Deere here, the snapper, I mean, there's a bunch of this stuff, and a tiller over here that, they were all showing weak to no spark. But while I'm troubleshooting it, let me show you what I do to troubleshoot a magneto before I go out and just buy a new one. So the first thing I do is get online and, look up the specs on whatever magneto I'm using, whether this looks like FC420V, so this is off of a Kawasaki engine, but you can find them on Briggs & Stratton stuff, on Kohler engines, Honda engines, and all that, but you can see how they're giving the data here. So the primary coil, you're looking at terminal A, which is that little connector that's on the back of the magneto, and the core, which is this part of the arms that stick out, these, whatever you want to call them, points. I wouldn't say point, but just the armatures there. So between A and C, so you'd have the positive on A and negative on C on your multimeter. And you're given a range, 0.48 to 0.72, 0.48 to 0.72 ohms. The secondary coil is measuring from the spark plug cable and going to the core again, so B and C, and you're given a range of 10.9 to 16.3 kilo ohms. This is an igniter. These are on an older Kawasaki engine, the FC420V, and it's kind of they use this instead of the old points, but now they don't even use this anymore, but that's a different story. But the same thing, you just measure off on the terminals and you get units of resistance, and found some more over here. This one's very similar. This is showing, once again, showing the igniter module test. Here, the magneto ignition coil resistance test. And here at the bottom, they're just giving you a subnote here for the results. If resistance is not within 0.48 to 0.72 ohms, replace the magneto ignition coil. And they're talking about that number one here. You can see it corresponds to this same resistance on your primary coil. And then same thing down here when you're looking at the secondary coil. If resistance is not within 10.9 to 16.3 kilo ohms, then replace the magneto. And then there's the igniter module test again. Interesting to note, over here they do give the spec for the ohms between the terminal and the case. But over here, because it's kind of shoddy when you're trying to get a reading off these things, off the igniters, and they're just saying just be sure to check the magneto first. If it's good, then just replace the igniter, right? If engine does not start, replace ignition module with a known good one. If a new igniter module does not solve the problems, test all other ignition system components. Well, that's the idea. We're trying to, when we're troubleshooting something, we're trying to narrow down the problem. So let's go take a look at some. All right, so you can see I dug into my little box of goodies here, and I have a bunch of old, used magnetos. And most of these I've taken them off of mowers that are being scrapped or whatever. And I just save them just in case, you know. Put this aside. And I jotted down some notes. On some of the specs that we should be seeing. And here's a multimeter. So I set it to ohms. Now this is an auto ranging. On other ones, you'll have to set it at 10 or 40x or whatever, so it'll be in the range. But this one is an auto sensing. Just set it to ohms, and let's grab one of these. So the primary, you're going from one of these poles here, the bar, over to the kill wire there. And there you can see it's reading 7.53 ohms. Now, I wrote down some of these specs here. They're saying the primary should be 0.8 to 1 ohm and the secondary 5.9 to 7.1 kilo ohms. On the ones we saw on the screen, they were totally different, weren't they? I'll have to go back and look. But that's why it's important to look and see what the spec is on that particular magneto that you're replacing, right? So there we have a 7.51, and that's on the primary. Now if we go to secondary, it'll go from that same point here on the bar over to your spark plug connector. There we go. Now this one is showing 9.56 kilo ohms. So according to this spec, it would be way out of spec, but according to the ones that we saw on the monitor there earlier, it would be in spec. But that's basically how you do it. All right. So you're just looking to see if any of those ranges on your primary and secondary are out. This one, let's do the same thing. Let's go from this pole over to the connector for your kill, and it's showing, it's kind of all over the place, isn't it? Look at that. There we go, 1.2 ohms, and that looks to be acceptable, right? But now if you take the same, this is, we're going over the secondary here, the same pole, and then go to your spark plug, and we're not reading anything at all. So that is definitely bad, right? So if you don't get any reading, then it's bad. It's been shorted out, whatever. Some of them will be kind of like this, where you can let's try another one. So there's the primary at 1.5. My lead here. And the secondary at 6.21 kilo ohms. So this one would be in spec, right? And that's basically it. It's really pretty easy. Just make sure you have the correct specifications for whatever magneto you're testing, and you can kind of see what range they're kind of in. And a lot of times, say if this secondary might be a little higher, and what'll happen, what you'll see on your out of coming out of your spark plug, the higher the resistance, then the less spark you have, right? So sometimes it'll just be a real weak spark that you see. It's still working, but it's out of spec. There's too much resistance, too high. Other times it'll be like this, where you're not reading anything at all, and of course you're not going to get any spark at all. So that is about it for the testing. A lot of times I save these so that if one goes bad on me, you know, I can dig in my box and find a replacement, right? And the things to watch out for when you're doing that, you can't just get any magneto and just pop it in. Like this one, I believe this one came off of a Kohler engine, and this one I'm not sure of, but when you're looking at it, you look at the mounting holes, make sure you can see how this one is just not going to line up, you know, even with the mounting holes, if they're, you know, in the exact same spot. But look at the poles here. They're, this one's way extended, and you're not going to be able to mount it on the factory mounts. Sometimes they are, let's see, yeah, look at this one. It's this one, I don't know if you can see it through the camera, but it's actually a little wider, and when you look at the mounting holes, they're kind of wide, and you can't mount it in. So not only just for fit, but if these poles are slightly different mounting wise, then it throws your timing off, right? So if your poles aren't lined up exactly where they should be when the magnet, you know, sweeps across, if it's off a little bit, if you're using something else that's mounted a little different, well, it's going to spark way before it should. You know, if it's over this way, over the other way, it might spark too late, you know, and it's just going to screw up your timing. Another thing to look for is the diameter of the flywheel. You know, on a smaller one, you'll see how, yeah, where you have a more pronounced curve here. Well, that's because the flywheel is smaller than, I think this is one of them that looks to be pretty large. This one too. So it looks like you can tell it's a larger diameter flywheel. This one especially. Let's put them side by side and see if you can see. Yeah, it's kind of hard to tell. But you'll notice when you put it up against the flywheel. Say if I put this small with the heavy curves on it up against a big flywheel, only these two edges of the points are going to be even close, right? What else? Just the mounting of it. Make sure that you have room where your kill switch is. It's usually the opposite side is face up, right? So this is usually down, and you know, by the engine, and when you position it, you need to have, you know, a long enough cable, you know, to reach your spark plug. You can see the difference here. This one's a shorty too. This one's even shorter. So that's basically the differences between them. You're going to have different ohm levels, and you're going to have different mounting provisions. So you got to fit, you know, you got to test form, fit, and function, right? So, but that's it in a nutshell. Yeah, well, that was about it. It's really quick and easy, and it's a way so that when you're troubleshooting and you know, try to find out why there's no spark, at least that's one of the pieces that you can eliminate, just the process of elimination, you know. And then you'll know if it's good or bad, and you know if you have to buy one or not, instead of just blindly going out and buying a magneto. I save a lot of the parts, And but it is there, you know, you have to test for form, fit, and function, right? You just can't slap any magneto in. It's got to fit physically. It's got to have the right resistance, the right specs, you know, that kind of thing, and the length of the cable for the spark plug. So, but that's about it. So it's really quick and easy. If you don't have a multimeter, you can find them on Amazon everywhere, and some are fairly affordable. If you just use it every once in a while, you can get one of the inexpensive ones, and they do just fine. But if you use it a lot, and you know you're checking, you know, voltage, continuity, whatever, you know, resistance on some circuit boards or like these magnetos, I use it all the time. So if you get a very nice one, it's really worth it if you use it a lot. But that's about it. So. Once again, thanks for watching. Be sure to subscribe and watch for my next video.